Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Welcome back to it. I am filming this on November 12th, Sunday, 9:36 p.m. You can obviously tell because it's dark outside. But, sorry, I got something in my hair. But, as y'all can tell from the title of this video, I'm going to be reacting to Bethany Joylin's, aka Haley, girl from Run Tree Hill, she has a song called Blue Sky, so I'm gonna be listening to that. If you see me looking off, looking that way, the way I'm looking, it's because I have my tablet right here that's gonna be playing the music, and I have it connected to a Bluetooth speaker so I can hear it better. But I have a lyric video of the song pulled up. Once again, I'm going to be reacting to Bethany Joylin's Blue Sky. So let's go ahead and play it. Okay, I'm gonna stop it right there for a second. So far, I'm loving it. I'm only a minute and 1 second into it, but so far, I'm really loving it. I love her vocals. That's the reason. Well, here's why I'm reacting to a Bethany Joylin song. I always knew she could sing because I've seen like one full season of One Tree Hill, and that's season one. I tried to get into season two, but I just started watching other shows and movies, and then I just forgot about it. Or I didn't forget about it, but I was just like, eh, I'll try and watch it some other time. I just haven't gotten back into it yet. But, I was scrolling on TikTok, like, 20 minutes ago. And I saw, like, her singing Halo, the song called Halo. And I really, 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 really love that song. And I'm like, ooh. So, I'm like, ooh, why don't I search for another song about, because I know she has other songs from it, so, and maybe to put out on her own, but and Blue Sky is one of the songs that popped up. I'm like, ooh, why not film my reaction video to one of the songs? So that's what I'm doing. Wondering what this is, it's string to my pants, but let's continue with it. What do I do? Oh, I think I turned it up. Yeah, that's what makes that noise. Okay, let's continue. Be my singing lesson, be my song. When I tell you I'm falling, you tell me I'm strong. The trees have grown tall, the birds have flown high, higher and higher. Goodbye, goodbye, goodbye. I'll fly over a rainbow, I'll be a sun kiss, sail around the planet Venus and send a long letter way back home. Says all that I know, all that I know is the blue sky. High, the blue sky. Okay, I'll pause it again. I think what would make this song 10 times better, because it sounds, it's good, but I don't know, for some reason it sounds kind of like dry, if that makes sense. I think if she added like a male background singer into the song, it would sound amazing, but it sounds kind of dry. I mean, I'm liking it, but now I'm like almost to the end of the song, And it sounds kind of dry, so if they added like a male background singer, I think this song would be like a 10 out of 10. So far, it's like a 7 out of 10. Or not even a 7, like a 6.7 out of 10. So, yeah, I think that's what would make the song a 10 out of 10 for me. But let's continue. Make sure I press the right button this time. Here we go. Up another song called Quicksand. If I feel like reacting to another one of her songs in the next video, I will, or in a different video, I will, but hang on, let me eat. Okay, so make sure I got everything situated with my tablet. Okay. Did I turn this off? No, I did not. Okay, so let's talk about it with Sally. So, Blue Sky by Bethany Joy Lenz. I'm hoping and praying I'm saying her name right. If I'm saying it wrong, I'm so sorry. But, I give that song like a 6.7 out of 10. It just, like I said, sounded kind of dry. Like, I feel like if she added, like, I don't even think it had to be like a male background singer. I mean, I'm thinking most likely male background singer would make it perfect. Maybe a female background singer or like harmonies. I don't know. It just sounded like it needed more something. But, I feel like I'm reacting to another one of her songs. I will, because I don't even know the last time she put out a song. Like, was that song on One Tree Hill, or did she put that song out on her own, or was that for another project? Like, let's do some investigative work. Okay, Googling. Bethany Joy Lenz. I love how she was the first one to pop up. Okay. So, music career is what I'm gonna type in. Career. Okay. Did Bethany Joy Lenz have a musical career? That pops up under People Also Ask. Well, her acting career, this is on People.com. Well, her acting career took off in 2003 when she was cast in One Tree Hill as kind-hearted Haley James Scott, whom she played for 9 seasons. Lenz always struggled acting with her passion for music. Forming the folk band Everly, which split in 2012 and releasing several albums and singles. Did she ever have like a solo one then? I'm just gonna type in music. Solo. Bethany Joy Lynn's music solo, that's what I have typed in. I'm gonna type in new music and see if that pops up, and if it doesn't, I'll type in last song. Ooh, she has a new song. Strawberries, this is on people.com. And it's an article headlined, Bethany Joy Lynn's playful new single, Strawberries, taps into female insecurities and coming out on top. Okay, I'm gonna read this whole article. When Bethany Joy Lynn moved to Nashville last summer, the actress and singer-songwriter felt inspired to write her first new single, Strawberries. Lynn, who is 42, wrote the lively track in which she ponders her insecurities and the unpredictability of life and love. In just 2 hours, the One Tree Hill alum was staying with a friend when she found herself making physical comparisons. I think that's why I love the song, because I feel like it's relatable. She tells People in this week's issue out on Friday, "As women, I feel like we often sit in this place of comparison, and I wanted to play with the juxtaposition. I hope you all know what word I'm trying to say. Juxtaposition. Okay, I'm gonna put the word on the screen now. That's the word I'm trying to say, and I just can't say it. Of the jealousy and comparison that we feel, but also how we find our sense of confidence if we don't compare, if we can all just enjoy each other. The song felt just like a fun, playful way to address those insecurities, but also come out on top with some confidence and laughter about it. Strawberries is the first in a new set of songs Lynn plans to release in the coming months. While her acting career took off in 2003 when she was cast in One Tree Hill's kind-hearted Haley James Scott, whom she played for 9 seasons, Lynn always juggled acting with a passion for music. Forming the folk band Everly was split in 2012 and released in several albums and singles. Okay, I already read that part. Lynn also performed on One Tree Hill and went on a concert tour with guest star Tyler Hilton and Gavin DeGraw, who sang the show's theme, "Back then I was trying to write pop, write for the show, and figure out what my sound was." So it calls, "Now this feels so connected to my own voice as a musician." Ooh, we better get fucking excited then. "Moving to Nashville a year ago was a deliberate move on her part because I felt like I had been through enough in my life," Lynn says. "I was ready to really put music at the front and center." Ooh, she ain't no actor anymore. She's a singer-songwriter, baby. The musician, who is also working on a newspaper for women and memoir, plans to perform some of her new music in Nashville over the next few months, including a sold-out show on August 12th at the Bluebird. This was posted before August 12th, obviously. I'm reading it like 3 months later, blah, blah, blah. At the Bluebird, a beloved local intuition. A local inspiration where some of the city's best singer-songwriters performed. The cafe earned international recognition. Okay, I'm gonna restart that whole sentence. Oh, where is the sentence? The cafe earned international recognition through its depiction on the CMT drama Nashville. I've seen every fucking, well, almost every single episode of the show Nashville, and I love that show. Like, that show is, to me, is, like, kind of underrated. "We have so many incredibly talented people here," Lynn acknowledges. "You really have to be with yourself if people are going to spend their money and come see you instead of any number of other brilliant, talented artists that night in Nashville. But I'm up for the challenge, and I'm really looking forward to just getting out there and having fun." Strawberries is available to stream and purchase on August 18th. AKA is out now, because I am recording this on November 12th. 3.5 months later, or whatever it is. So, should I, for the next video, react to the song Strawberries? And just hope it doesn't get copyrighted, because I believe Blue Skies is like an old song. Like, let me Google Blue Skies. Because I don't want to go edit this and then try to post it and then get copyright blocked worldwide. Blue Skies. Or it's called Blue Sky. Sorry, I keep on saying Blue Skies. It's Blue Sky. Oh, it's featured in the One Tree Hill series finale. Ooh, that's cool. So it is One Tree Hill, like I had a feeling of. Okay, but I am gonna end this video here. So if you like this video, don't forget to like it. If you're not already subscribed, hit that subscribe button and turn on that notification bell to get notified when the next video gets posted. I've been trying to do more like upbeat videos and trying to lean off the sad and depressed videos. Like I said, I'll talk more about Matthew Perry when his official cause of death, like, was it a heart attack, was it a stroke, was it something else, like, when all that is out, all we know is his time of death and then the informant and all that. His time of death, from what I believe, remember, is 4:17 p.m. on Saturday, October 28th. I remember that because it was on my dog's birthday, which is great. But I am gonna end this video, like I just said, so I'll see you on the next one. Peace, guys. Peace.